Today, I'm going to explain the movie called Not Another Teen Movie from 2001. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care, and I hope you enjoy it. The movie starts with a girl named Janie. Janie is watching a romantic movie in her room. She gets turned on and pulls out a vibrator from her sock drawer. She puts it down her pants and starts pleasuring herself. Without notice, all of her family members, including some kids, came into her room with a cake. Today was Janie's birthday, and they entered her room to surprise her. Janie doesn't know what to do, and tries to act naturally despite having been caught masturbating and on the verge of orgasm. But Janie's dog pulls her blanket off the bed, and the vibrator goes flying through the air and lands on the cake. Janie was now fully exposed, and everyone realized what she had been doing. After some time, Janie's dad drops her and her brother off at school. Janie is a nerdy student, and everyone in school thinks she is lame and boring, and that's why she doesn't have a boyfriend. Her brother, Mitch, always bullies her about this. Janie's dad drops them off at school and leaves. Janie meets up with one of her friends, Ricky. Ricky likes Janie, and he always tries to impress her, but Janie only sees him as a good friend. Janie's brother, Mitch, tells his friends that they should lose their virginity soon, and they make a pact to have sex before graduation, despite still being freshmen. Mitch sees a girl named Amanda, who is very attractive. Mitch loses his mind after seeing her, and we realize that Mitch has had a crush on her for a long time. We see the most popular and handsome guy in the school. His name is Jake. All the girls had a crush on him, but Jake is already in a relationship with the head cheerleader, Priscilla. Priscilla goes to Jake and tells him she wants to talk to him in private. She tells him she wants to break up with him because now she likes someone else. Jake gets upset and can't understand how any girl would want to leave a handsome guy like him. Jake's friend tells him that Priscilla is beautiful and she will be the prom queen this year, as always. Jake says she only looks beautiful because she uses makeup, and any girl can be the prom queen if they wear makeup. In response to this comment, Jake's friend, Austin, makes a bet with Jake, challenging him to make the lamest, least attractive girl in the school the prom queen. Jake accepts the bet. Soon after, Janie was walking in front of them, and Austin chooses Janie as Jake's prom queen. Jake says no, this girl can never be the prom queen. But still, he agrees to try to win the bet. Meanwhile, Ricky is trying to impress Janie, and he reads a poem in front of the whole class. But Janie couldn't understand the meaning of the poem. We also see that Janie's brother Mitch and two of his friends creep around the girls' bathroom to spy on them. They climb through the AC vent to peep at the girls, but the vent can't support their weight and it breaks, causing them to fall into a classroom with another girl. As punishment, Mitch and his friends get detention. In the cafeteria, Jake strikes up a conversation with Janie during lunchtime, and he asks her to go on a date with him. But Janie rejects him because she finds it odd that Jake is only talking to her now for the first time in 6 years. Jake goes to the playground and watches some guys playing football. Actually, Jake is also a football player, but he was suspended from the team because of an incident where he tackled a guy so hard that he died. That evening, Janie is thinking about Jake and talks to her father about him. Her father encourages her to go on a date with him. Meanwhile, Jake goes to his sister, Catherine, and asks her to give him some tips about impressing Janie. Catherine suggests that he do something kind for her. The next day, Jake attempts to save Janie's brother from some bullies to gain her affection. But instead, he mistakenly beats her father since Jake saw him being rough with her brother. So that idea didn't exactly work out as planned. His next idea was to sing a song in front of everyone to impress Janie. The song he chooses to sing is Janie's Got a Gun by Aerosmith because it has her name in the lyrics. But everyone nearby takes the lyrics literally and thinks that Janie actually has a gun on her. They think Jake is trying to warn them of danger, and the misunderstanding causes panic as everyone runs away screaming. The police eventually show up and arrest her. Janie was so fed up with the unwanted attention from Jake, so she goes to his house and tells him not to follow her anymore. But before she leaves, Jake tells her that he wants to show her something. Jake takes off all his clothes and stands in front of Janie completely naked, except for whipped cream covering his junk. But Janie is not impressed by this. Instead, she gets mad at him and leaves. Some days later, Jake goes to Janie's house and brings his sister Catherine. He wants to take Janie to a party, and he brings Catherine so that she can do her makeup. Really, all she does is remove her glasses and let her hair down from her ponytail. But when Janie comes downstairs after getting ready, Jake is surprised and struck by her beauty. Mitch and his friends are at the party already, and Mitch had written a letter to Amanda in an attempt to impress her. After some time, when Jake and Janie arrive at the party, everyone is shocked to see Janie's new look. As the night goes on, Janie gets drunk and she jumps into the swimming pool. Jake's ex-girlfriend Priscilla approaches Janie and starts making fun of her. This upsets Janie and she leaves the party. At night, Jake goes to Janie's house to meet her. They talk about their past and their families. Janie tells him she wants to join an art school in Paris. They get so close while talking to each other, and they were about to kiss, but the situation gets a bit awkward and they pull back. Now Jake starts to feel like he really likes her, and he leaves her house for the night. The next day, Priscilla again insults Janie, but this time, Janie doesn't care about her. Jake's friend reminds him about the bet, and Jake goes to Janie and asks her if she wants to go to the prom with him. Janie accepts his proposal and agrees to go to prom as his date. The next day was the school football match. Jake is still suspended from the team, but his team was about to lose, and some players were injured too. The coach has no option but to send Jake onto the field to play. But it's no good because the team loses the match once again because of Jake. After the match, Janie comforts him, saying that at least he tried his best. Austin appears and blames Jake for the team's loss. To get payback, he will tell the truth to Janie. Jake says something in Janie's ear and tells her the truth about their relationship. He tells her he got to be close with her because he had placed a bet with his friend. Janie is devastated to hear this, and she leaves. Austin tells Jake that he didn't say anything to Janie, and Jake has made a terrible mistake. Jake and Janie spend some time apart, and they really miss each other because they were actually in love. Now it's the day of prom night. Austin takes Janie with him to the prom, and Jake goes to prom with his sister, Catherine. Janie's brother, Mitch, finds Amanda and approaches her to give her the love letter. Amanda seemingly likes what he wrote and smiles after reading the letter. She takes him to a room to have sex. Meanwhile, Janie and Austin are dancing together, and Jake is also dancing with Catherine. Catherine starts kissing Jake while dancing, and Janie sees this, and she's heartbroken once again, so she leaves the prom. The principal announces the prom king and queen of the year. Jake becomes the prom king, but the principal says, "This year we have two prom queens." Priscilla thinks that maybe she and Janie were this year's prom queens, but the prom queens of the year are two twin girls. After this, Janie goes somewhere with Austin. Jake finds out from his friend that Janie went to a hotel with Austin to have sex. Jake finds Ricky and tells him he loves Janie as well. Now it's a race to get to her. Jake gets to the hotel room first, and he hears sex noises from the door. But when he goes inside the room, he sees that Austin was having sex with Priscilla instead of Janie, and Priscilla's boyfriend was recording them. Jake learns that Janie went to her house, and so he heads there as well. When Jake reaches her house, he finds out that Janie has gone to the airport to go to Paris to study art. Jake runs to the airport. Ricky was also after him, but out of nowhere, he gets hit by a bus and dies. Jake reaches the airport just in time to see that Janie was about to board the plane. He throws a football in Janie's face and stops her from boarding. Jake runs up to her and he professes his love for her. He tells her that he might have met her because of the bet, but when he really got to know her, he fell in love. Janie is charmed by him, and she cancels her plans for Paris. They kiss each other passionately. Janie's best friend Ricky was watching them, and he applauds. The movie ends here with this romantic scene. To watch more explanations of these kinds of movies, click on the videos on your screen. And don't forget to let me know how you feel about today's video in the comments down below. And at last, I will say, stay safe, stay well, thanks.